I'm Steve Sellers, Chief of Police for Albemarle County, Virginia, and I'm joined up here today by Chief Timothy Longo, the Charlottesville Police Department, and Ms. Denise Lunsford, the County Prosecutor for Albemarle County. I'm also joined behind me by the investigative team that's been involved in the investigation in one way or another for the Hannah Graham case. On behalf of the Albemarle County Police Department and my colleague, Chief Longo, our sincere appreciation goes out to many community members and citizens who assisted in the search for Hannah Graham. War supported our efforts each and every day behind the scenes. Our efforts to this point would not be possible without the dedication and commitment from our partners from the Virginia Department of Emergency Management, the FBI, the Virginia State Police, and the Albemarle County Sheriff's Department Search and Rescue Team. Too numerous to mention, we are also grateful for the public safety professionals who contributed resources to this effort. Following the discovery of Hannah Graham's remains in Albemarle County by a sergeant from the Chesterfield County Sheriff's Office on October 18th, the criminal investigation transitioned from the Charlottesville Police Department to the Albemarle County Police Department. This transition was made extremely easy since Chief Longo requested our involvement in the search and investigation at the very early stages. To best maintain continuity throughout the investigation, Chief Longo graciously allowed some of his resources to continue working with my investigative team throughout the last several months. Following an extensive investigation and successful multi-jurisdictional partnership, the Albemarle County Police Department has completed our investigation into the disappearance and death of Hannah Graham. Yesterday afternoon, Albemarle County and Charlottesville City Police detectives met with Fairfax County authorities to serve a capias and four indictments on Jesse Matthew. This case now officially transitions over to the Office of the Commonwealth Attorney for prosecution. To talk about the charges and the legal process to follow, please allow me to introduce Ms. Denise Lunsford, the Albemarle County Prosecutor.
Thank you, Colonel. My name is Denise Lunsford. I'm the Commonwealth's Attorney for Albemarle County. On Monday, February 2, 2015, Jesse Matthew Jr. was indicted in Albemarle County for abduction and murder of Hannah Graham. Specifically, Mr. Matthew was indicted for first-degree murder and abduction with the intent to defile occurring on or about September 13, 2014. Additionally, he was indicted for two charges of reckless driving for incidents occurring on September 20 of 2014. These indictments signal the beginning of the next phase in what has been an incredibly difficult process for the family of Hannah Graham, for our community, and for the men and women of the many departments and agencies who have worked on this matter since September of last year. The prosecutions for the abduction and murder of Hannah will bring Mr. Matthew to justice for these crimes, crimes that were committed against Hannah Graham, against her family, and against our community. There are likely many questions that you have that I can't answer. As an attorney involved in a matter that may be tried to a jury, I'm ethically prohibited from making statements that may interfere with the fairness of a trial. Our office has always strictly adhered to this rule, and this case is no different. As a result, I will not be commenting on the evidence, on the penalty that may be sought, or on trial strategy. However, I hope that I can answer some of the questions that I believe you may have. You will note that Mr. Matthew is charged with first-degree murder and abduction with the intent to defile. He is not charged with capital murder. The decision of how to charge in a specific case is very difficult, and oftentimes there are many considerations that go into charging decisions. I'm not going to discuss the specific facts and circumstances that led to this consideration for ethical reasons. However, understand that a great deal of serious thought went into this determination, including the impact on the community, the Grahams, and the need to provide Mr. Matthew with a fair trial. I have discussed this matter with the Grahams on many occasions, and they are aware of the indictments. I'm not going to comment further on my conversations with them. However, on behalf of everyone involved in this matter, I ask that you please respect this family and what they have been through. Do not contact them out of the need for a story or the desire to make a headline. Allow these people their peace. The family of Morgan Harrington has also been made aware of these indictments, and again, I will not comment on those conversations. There are no pending charges against Mr. Matthew with respect to Morgan Harrington. Each investigation takes its own course. Law enforcement has been working diligently on all of these matters, and the simple fact is that the case involving Hannah Graham was ready to be charged first. If and when a determination is made regarding the case involving Morgan Harrington, the community will be advised at the appropriate time. The next step in this process is that Mr. Matthew will have a first appearance in Albemarle Circuit Court. That first appearance is currently scheduled for Wednesday, February 18 at 11 a.m. At that time, Mr. Matthew will be advised of his right to counsel and a new date will be scheduled. He is not expected to appear in person. He is expected to have his first appearance by video. Colonel Sellers has mentioned the agencies involved in the search for Hannah, and I want to comment specifically on the professionals who participated in this investigation into her disappearance and death. Throughout the course of this investigation, I worked very closely with the Albemarle County Police Department, the Charlottesville Police Department, and the Virginia State Police, and specifically with most of the individual officers involved in this investigation, many of whom you see up here. These departments and individuals came together as Team Hannah, and they brought the same high quality of professionalism to this investigation that I've seen them display many, many times in the past. The only difference between what they did in this case and what they did in any other case is the amount of outside attention that's been focused on this matter. It's because of the efforts of these professionals and these departments that we're here today to begin the process of seeking justice for Hannah Graham and for this community through the courts. And for that, I'm sincerely thankful for everyone on Team Hannah. We will attempt to answer some of your questions now, but understand that, as I discussed previously, my ability to discuss the facts or specifics of the investigation is limited.
I know the body was found in Albemarle County. How about, can you say for certain that the murder happened in Albemarle County?
Jurisdiction in Albemarle County is permitted, or venue in Albemarle County is permitted, because that's where the body is found. Other than that, I'm not going to comment. A comment has previously been made on the cause of death, and I'm not going to go into that any further.
Can you give us an understanding given the fact that Jesse Matthews is charged in a separate case from 2005 where he's being held in Fairfax, how this will all play out? Does he become now Albemarle County's priority, or is that a case that will be heard there first before this one is addressed?
It's hard to say how the cases will proceed in terms of which will go first. As you may know, Fairfax has a date scheduled for Friday, I think, to schedule a trial date. The two cases are sort of connected because there's the same defendant. Other than that, it really doesn't matter which prosecution goes first. It only matters that we're able to provide a fair trial.
Can you just, as an individual who's been focused on this as part of Team Hannah, just speak from one's heart about what this moment means? There have been a series of women, Hannah Graham, who was believed to have been sexually assaulted and then killed by this man. This has got to be a gut check to this community and for you, a massive moment of relief that you think is finally done.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, I'm very proud of the effort that these officers put into this case, of all these officers and departments of working together and pulling together as a team from September 13, 14 through today. I'm proud of the work that they've done, and I'm pleased that we're able to bring these charges.
Lunsford, can you say anything about any of the evidence that led to these charges? Was there a DNA link? Can you give any indication?
I can't comment on the evidence for the ethical considerations that I cited earlier. Yes, sir.
Clearly, these were horrific crimes in every way, and clearly, you mentioned capital murder was something you considered. Can justice be served without bringing that charge, or does the community have a right, and a jury have a right to hear that charge?
What charge?
Capital murder.
The charges that the jury will hear are the charges that the prosecutor feels comfortable and feels the prosecutor has probable cause to bring. in this case, first-degree murder and abduction with the intent to defile. The penalty for the two felony charges, the abduction with the intent and the first-degree murder, are 20 years to life. So it's a substantial penalty that the jury will be able to consider. There have been no discussions with the defendant at this point.
Has he said anything?
I can't comment any further.
Why did you go for the death penalty? Chief, do you think this is the right thing?
No death penalty.